Hello everybody, I am Kilimanjaro 808. We're going to do an update video on my Sicily 1943 82nd Airborne impression. This is for the jump into Sicily. I don't have any gear on right now. I'm actually going to redo my gear. Looking at getting some new gear from at the front, the web belt, suspenders, musette bag. Being that I'm doing an officer impression, probably get a map case, new holster, just a bunch of other things. I have a helmet with the OD3 khaki helmet on, so I don't have to worry about too much about head gear at least. Just maybe a garrison cap. What else? And I do have an M1A1 carbine. I'm down to one now. I had two King Arms M1A1 carbines. I traded one off to someone up in Chicago area. It's on its way right now for an A&K Emma Garand. So I'll be doing a review on that rifle when I get it and an after action report on it in time. And as you can see, I'll just cover what improvements I've made to this. Again, no gear. You're gonna have to wait for that in the future. We're just gonna do the basic jacket, trousers, shirt. So the uniform itself has not changed. It's basically the same thing. The only modification that I will be doing is double stitching the groin area over here. This is infamous on the reinforced and non-reinforced M42s to rip open over time, especially on the non-reinforced versions where you have the leg ties. If you have those things too tight, as with what happened when I sold my 101st one to a friend, he had his leg ties on too tight and he ended up ripping open the crotch area, and ooh, it was a mess. You're not supposed to have too much things in your pockets and you can't have the leg ties on too tight. Same goes for the non-reinforced version. You don't want to have too many things in your pockets, and it's always a good idea to double stitch this area. It's really infamous and really bad when this thing pops, you know, shreds open. It's a mess. So that's probably what I'm going to do as a modification to the trousers, is the uniform itself. Apart from that, changes that I made are I now have new boots. These are from At the Front. I got them off eBay for $100. First, I thought they were from Epic Militaria because I had a couple other reenactors look at them on Instagram, and everyone back and forth, they're like, no, it's At the Front, no, it's Epic Militaria. But I looked inside and it says ATF manufacturing contract, so boom, At the Front. It might be their, I think they're not the higher end, like the $250 boots, but I think it's like the $179 ones, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. They don't have them in. Last time I checked, they're probably going to get a new shipment in sometime, but they're stiff as a rock right now, really hard. And the color on video, this is the actual color of the boots in real life, in the flesh. This is not a lens flare or anything like that. So that's one thing I'm proud of. You know, they're well made. Gotta give them a nice spit shine eventually. Yeah, I gotta do some breaking into these things, probably walk around the house with these on or something like that. I guess I'll take my jacket off now. So as we covered in the last video, I made this impression. I've stuck on some Varsity Tenet bars on the epaulets of my jacket. This damn jacket belt is coming off. So if you want to see the backside, bed sheet's coming off. Gotta stop using this bed to make videos. It's because nobody wants to film me but myself. I don't trust anybody unless it's a really good camera operator or something like that. So the most noticeable change from last time, I'm going to take all of this off anyway. It's getting kind of hot. Is, as you can see, I have now have an At the Front khaki officer shirt. This is something that you used in Sicily. Normally it's not permitted for anyone to wear, in Europe at least, and in the Mediterranean, to have worn a khaki shirt on field duty or in combat. But being in the conditions that Sicily was, you know, Sicily and Italy are very hot places in the summer, they were permitted to wear the khaki shirts because of the very hot weather. And I just got a white t-shirt underneath this, being, you know, mid-war, really war, they were using white t-shirts. Late war, they were using green t-shirts, so that's staying true to it as well. One of the reasons why I bought it was because it had the 82nd Airborne patch and the collar insignia already on it. I changed it to a First Lieutenant bar because It had a lieutenant colonel insignia. I have this upstairs somewhere. Yeah, very impressive. You know, it fits well. It's a little long on me, a little bit wide too, but oh well. Fits me pretty good from what I see. And if I ever grow, you know, I'll fit into it. I'd rather have it just a little loose than too tight. Like my old shirt, it didn't even fit me. Oh, the collar part didn't fit me when I tried buttoning up this part. It didn't even fit me. I was skin tight too. It was like really, really, I couldn't even breathe with that thing on. So that's pretty much the only improvements I've made as of now. January 17th, 2018. So hopefully in the future, sometime this year, I'll have a complete impression. This is just a improvement on how it was last year. Last year was kind of like a rough base of it, pretty much. So again, I got some items to pick up. I've made some improvements and there's still some more improvements to come along the way. And I've also got more impressions to come in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching. You have a good night.